to sing from the sky above. Wow, that is beautiful. Hello again, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. And we're ready to bring you the NBA on 2K Sports. Our starting lineups, a look at the matchups here and who we'll see for our starting five for both teams. First for the Pistons. And for the Clippers.
Well, I tell you what, the Clippers playing in the Western Conference knew they'd have to take care of business facing Eastern Conference opponents, and they did. 21-9 against the East, and a bunch of highlight real plays along the way.
Tip-off goes to the Clippers. Here's Beverly. Number 40. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. And for the Clippers against the East, they had a winning record against every division out there. That's exactly what any coach, Steve, would hope for at the start of the season.
And you'll remember the Clippers went on that big streak in December, and I think the early part of the season they won 17 games in a row. A lot of those games out on the road back east. So I thought that established the tone for the Clippers for last year.
The first one falls.
Detroit really is one of the younger teams in the league as far as their core and future are concerned. It's always nice to kind of think, what might they become going forward? But they are going to struggle at times, especially on the road.
And so he hits both. Pistons did have big problems getting wins on the road, and that is one of the reasons why the fans were a bit frustrated with how the team developed over the course of last year. Steve, they just couldn't finish off games when they were the road team.
Yeah, that's right, Kevin. Just 11-30 away from the Palace. And, you know, when you're a young team, it takes a lot of mental toughness and growth to be able to close out games on the road. It's something they're still learning.
Now here's Leonard, following the miss by Griffin. Right at the free throw line, and the shot is good.
You know, his ability is matched only by his energy, guys. I mean, he's usually in the middle of everything for his team.
Jackson kicks to Griffin. Back to Jackson. Snell. Nice ball movement by Detroit. Now the dish to Griffin. Just fine on the clock. Hits it from three-point range. Griffin's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. First quarter, just over a minute played. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
I was able to speak with Dwayne Casey for a moment. I asked him if he had a plan for all the speed he'll be up against, and he told me a key would be transition defense, saying speed shows up most in the transition game, and we feel if we take that away from them, we have a major advantage. Back to you.
Thanks, Doris.
I tell you what, fellas, he loves those mid-range jumpers. I mean, that's where he makes his money.
He dishes it to Beverly. A floater, and the defense didn't have position. They whistle a blocking foul, and he'll go to the line.
One of the problems for the Pistons last season was they always seemed to come out after halftime flat. Just couldn't sustain the kind of intensity and focus needed to win consistently. That was a big part of why they had such a tough year.
And the first one drops. Well, going back to the Pistons, the third quarter for them was by far their worst scoring quarter. Several points lower than any other quarter they played in, and with the sample size you get over the course of a season, that is no accident.
Well, you know, what you think about now with a team like this is that if it's young, maybe they're not used to the tweaks and the adjustments that other teams are making at them over the halftime break. So this is an area for improvement for this Detroit team.
Pistons keep it alive. He feeds it to Drummond. Tries again, and that's 2 points on the layup.
Man, a gaping hole in the defense that time, and he didn't waste any time getting through it.
Here's Beverly. He passes to Leonard. Dishes it to Beverly. Passes it to George. Lets it go with a three. Shot's good. George has got himself on the board with three there.
And you can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter. On the wing, Jackson, defended by Beverly. Back to Jackson. Pass to Griffin. Six to shoot. The Pistons need to get off a shot here. There's the triple. It's hauled in by the Clippers. Kicks to George. From past the arc. The shot misses. And it's Detroit the other way. Feeds it to Jackson. Snell pulls up on the wing. And there's another one for the Pistons.
Textbook right there. Nice pass, great catch, beautiful finish.
And Beverly kicks to George. And there's the feed to Beverly. Leonard on the wing. Leonard off a bit from George. And Leonard gets it to go. Leonard's got 5 now.
Boy, that was a rugged screen set there, fellas. And the defense didn't even try to go through that one.
Pistons trail by 3. Outside Jackson. Picked by Griffin. Shot clock at 6. And the bucket counts. He is on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a 3-point play.
Heard the whistle and still kept his focus, able to knock that down.
And that is not easy, Steve. I mean, to take the bump, to maintain control of your body, and put it in the hole, tremendous play.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
Not the guy you want to see taking too many free throws. Last season, his numbers among the worst in the league.
And, you know, that's not the kind of percentage any player wants to see next to his name at the end of the season. You know, for a long time, people would look at Staples as the Lakers' home where the Clippers just happened to be sharing space. But the Clippers let everybody know that they called this Staples Center home as well last year. And I thought they were a force in front of their rabid fans.
Now, here is George. Here's the teardrop. And it's good on the way in. George has got 5 points so far.
That's such a field shot, that floater over the top.
And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here. Well, Clark, as you said, the Clippers really starting to make waves on the landscape here in L.A. as they surpassed the Lakers in wins last season. You know, a big part of that was, Steve, their ability to win here at home.
Yeah, 32 wins here at Staples. And when they got out and ran, this place was really rocking. And this Clipper team has a roster full of guys that can make a play that ignites a crowd. And some new additions this year, new coaching staff. A lot going on for this Clipper team.
Here's Jackson. Paul George making his last shot. There's the bucket. Good.
It's been a very efficient first quarter for him. He's creating good opportunities and converting those that he creates. Hey, I think we all knew that the Clippers were good last year, but we really took notice when they rattled off those 17 wins in a row in December. That was a franchise record, which had previously been 11, and that's when the league really took notice.
The Clippers trail. Here's Beverly. Back to George. From the wing. And the Clippers getting another bucket right there. Well, it was the year of the win streak last season with Miami doing what they did and Denver getting hot as well. But you know, Steve, the Clippers had the first lengthy win streak and turned some heads earlier in the season.
Yeah, what was that, about 17 games in a row they won? And I thought that kind of established the Clippers in the West, put a little fear in the rest of the conference, and gave L.A. a swagger that I thought helped them get through the rest of the season.
Took the opportunity when he saw it.
Another lead change. How many of these are we going to have?
I don't know, Steve, but the momentum of this game has certainly swung like a pendulum.
And so here are the Clippers. They trail by one. Outside Leonard. Number 40 defended by Drummond. And the basket is good. Got it to go through on the contact, so a free throw coming up. A great opportunity for a three-point play. The Clippers shooting their fifth free throw of the game here.
Well, pretty good numbers for this club a year ago, Kevin. 78% as a team from the free throw line.
You know, Kevin, they would love to post a similar percentage again this season. I mean, I think that's safe to say they'd love to shoot free throws as well as they did a year ago.
Detroit's gone 1-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Now the pass to Rose. Nice ball movement by Detroit. Lock at six. Passes it to Galloway. No good with the triple. LA's gone 2-4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Here's Beverly. Rose with the block. Number six. He's guarded by Williams. Pass to Galloway. Shoots the three. And it's the Clippers with the rebound.
Well, with that much space off the pick, you've got to drop that in.
Yeah, you got to make that one. I mean, that's a high-quality shot you should make 9 out of 10 times.
Back to Williams. He kicks it to Beverly. Good. Nice assist for Williams. Beverly's got five.
Boy, has there been any defense played yet in this game?
Nope. This game has been all about rapid-fire offense early.
Pistons trailed by five. Outside Rose. The pass to Galloway. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own.
How about that? They respond to a three-pointer with a quick three of their own.
Yeah, terrific. Great back-and-forth sequence right there.
The Clippers have gotten 7 of their first 10 attempts to fall so far. Excellent pace to their offense. The dish to Beverly. On the wing, Williams. From 15 feet away, no good.
Looked like an easy 2 points right there.
You know he's kicking himself for that miss.
They set the pick. Galloway, the pass to Rose. And the Pistons getting another bucket right there. And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here.
Yeah, guys, I think he feels like he can make a few improvements during this timeout. Just kind of make a couple of adjustments to get his club back on track.
You know, coaches are always tweaking and tinkering with things mid-game. Actually, sometimes they overdo it.
And the Clippers making a switch here. .116 left to play here in the first. Williams gets to Beverly. Pass to Harkless. Beverly. Outside Williams. 5 to shoot. Number 41. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play.
Boy, he just battled through that initial impact and somehow willed it in.
Excellent concentration. That's what you like to see.
And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for Los Angeles.
Boy, the three-point shot has really been dropping for him early on.
And they're sharing the ball, too, which I love. They're piling up the assist. We're seeing great offensive movement.
That was a good rebound right there, but they haven't been very strong on the glass so far.
Well, they've got to meet the energy that they're facing right now. So important to battle on the boards.
44 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Here's Beverly. 5 points in the game. Here's Harkless. Kept alive. Number 41. That's good.
See how he used the rim to protect the ball perfectly from the defender on that reverse.
The Pistons trailing. Now here's Rhodes. The eight-footer. Again, the Pistons score.
Good job there, Kevin, getting himself a little space on the inside.
Los Angeles has gone 3-6, 50% from deep so far tonight. And they call an illegal screen here.
Well, if you're going to set a screen like that, you've got to make sure your feet are set.
I agree with you, and I thought maybe he was set that time, Steve. I thought it was a good screen on his part.
...11 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Passes to Galloway. It's good. This time the assist from Rhodes. And now a three-point Piston lead. Clark, you talked about a back-and-forth game. This is the definition of
it. Yeah, no doubt about it, Kevin. I mean, not even through the first half, and it's been one heck of a battle.
Well, these are the kinds of games you love. I mean, two good teams going head-to-head, an even matchup, and both sides very competitive, on their toes tonight.
It's the end of the first with a tie game here, and already these offenses, Clark, are clicking. We'll be back shortly live from Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles. Welcome back, folks. We have a close game here at the start of the second quarter of play. And taking a look at Los Angeles' performance here, Clark and Steve, what have they been doing or not doing?
And I thought the key in that first quarter was the offensive aggressiveness. They attacked the rim and got to the foul line.
And I sense they're really feeling good about playing at home, taking advantage of the home court.
Now here's Rhodes. Five on the clock. Number six. Banked in off the glass.
I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
I agree. They need more energy in the post, maybe some double teaming. They've got to get their defense in gear.
Now, here's Green. He dishes it to Beverly. He feeds it to Williams. For the three. And another three for the Clippers.
You know, even though he doesn't really have the long-range ability on a consistent level, he can knock down some open ones.
Detroit's gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. Pass to Galloway. Pistons passing it around. Six on the shot clock. Number six. And another three for Detroit.
You know, neither team has really been able to get the edge.
Yeah, this has been a tight one here. Nail biter, just going back and forth right now.
Dishes to Beverly. Kicks it to Green. Right side, Green. Outside, Williams. From downtown. Feeds to Harkless. Another shot. He lays it in. He's got six. We're now about 2 minutes into the second quarter. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, over to you.
Hey, guys, well, the Clippers owe a lot of their success to how they bonded with team chemistry. Chris Paul said, quote, "It matters a lot when you really, truly care about somebody. You'll dive on the floor for them. You'll run through that screen for them. You really genuinely care how they feel. It just means a little bit more." That was certainly evident in how they played last year, as well as how they interacted. We'll see if they can keep that same fun going this year, guys.
Yeah, plenty of camaraderie in that locker room. Thanks, Doris. Here's Rose after the made shot from Mo Harkins. And there's the pass to Galloway. Knocks down the three ball. He's got nine.
And what jumps out at you guys, the assist totals. I mean, they have been dominant in that category. It's the ball movement, the player movement, a great rhythm to their offense.
Clearly seems to me a different mindset between these teams.
And here is Williams. Following the three from Galloway. And it's good. Pop through contact, hits the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
Boy, he just battled through that initial impact and somehow willed it in.
Excellent concentration. That's what you like to see.
The Pistons making a change here. The Clippers have hit most of their free throws tonight, 5 of 6. Shooting one. And the free throw, no good. The Pistons have gone 3 of 4 from the floor here in the second quarter. The feed to Drummond. Soft touch off the glass. And the Pistons lead by one.
Great interplay there between those two teammates.
Williams gets a screen from Green. Williams kicks to Green. The dish to Harkless. Number 41. No luck. Nice D from Griffin.
Pretty good defense there. I mean, that's a shot that he can make, but they really challenged him.
Out of bounds. Pistons ball. Detroit keeps possession. Detroit making a switch here. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. And it's Drummond missing. Los Angeles has gone 5 of 9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. Leonard attacking. Williams sinks the triple. Williams has got 6 points in the quarter.
It was a slow start for him, but he started to take off since we hit the second quarter, guys.
Back to Griffin. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Exceptional play to take the bump and still get it up and down.
Yeah, way to stay with it and look to finish the play right there.
This is his second trip to the free throw line. Reggie Jackson's checked in for the Pistons. Here's Williams. 9 points in the game so far. Outside Leonard. Fires the three. Good. Nice assist for Williams. Williams has got his fourth assist in this one. Now Jackson. 5 points in the game. Snell. Back to Jackson. Fires from deep. That is good. Jackson's got his third basket of the night right there. It has been nip and tuck through the first half.
No kidding. I mean, neither team has been able to hold the lead for any length of time, guys.
Steve, so close.
Well, such a seesaw affair back and forth. This has been an unbelievable game to watch.
And the Clippers making a change here. Beverly's checked in. Here's Leonard. He's got 8. Green with a screen for Leonard. He kicks to Beverly. Number 20. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
Well, and the bounce pass was the key to the play.
Detroit's gone 6 of 11 when they've taken the three-point shot tonight. Very respectable. Pass to Griffin. Pistons passing it around. Jackson misses. The Clippers have gone 7-9 in their field goal attempts here in the second quarter. Pretty good offense. Back to Leonard. And he draws body contact. Looked like a blocking foul, and he was in the shooting motion. So he'll head to the free throw line.
Detroit needs to do a better job guarding against Leonard.
Two shots.
He's got 8 points, and he's got two baskets from out in three-point land.
I'm sure they'd like to get him a few more of those, so look for them to run some screens for him, try to pop him open.
And he makes the first. Paul George, he's checked in for Green. Leonard hits them both.
And at the free throw line, it's all about consistency with him. Same routine, same stroke.
Jackson with it. He's got 8. Passes it to Griffin. He dishes it to Jackson. Clock at 6. Let's it go from deep. The Pistons rebound. Los Angeles leading by 4. Here's Beverly, and the basket is good. The call goes his way, and we could be looking at a 3-point play. He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
One shot.
And that one misses.
Free throws haven't been too kind to them here in the second quarter. I mean, you have the lead with the ability to extend that lead. In order for that to happen, you've got to make your free throw.
To halt the run, gets it to go. He's got 5.
You know, the defense didn't exactly try to fight around that screen, and that's why it turned into the easy basket.
Number 5. Another one falls for the Clippers.
The entire defense was frozen footed. Nobody picked up the shooter, Kevin.
Pistons trailed by 5. And a chance here to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Guys, Doc Rivers, the new head coach of the Los Angeles Clippers, said after last season, quote, there were times last year when they were the best team in the league. So I clearly think this is an extremely talented basketball team. But can we do that now in the postseason as opposed to just the regular season? That'll be the true test, gentlemen.
Yeah, championship mentality, Doris. Good point. Thanks. Here's Griffin. 9 points in the game so far. And out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession.
Celtics ball.
Clippers leading by 5. Outside Leonard. Back to George. Launches it. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
They can't afford to give him that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you got to fight over the top of that.
Now here's Jackson. He's got 8. Left side, Griffin. Lets the 3 fly. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Here's Beverly. Gives him the lead pass.
Oh, unbelievable.
How did he do that?
He threw down that 360 like it was no problem, no problem at all. That's insane skill.
The guys on the bench are just falling all over themselves.
Yeah, they love one of the plays of the year, possibly.
Now here's Jackson. He
He feeds it to Drummond. Backs in. Pass to Jackson. Just five to shoot. Snell. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson. Jackson's got four assists in the game.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
The Clippers in the lead. Kicks it to Beverly. 58 seconds left to play here in the half. This one for three. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
How about the passing? They're moving the ball without any thought, without any agenda.
It's hard to overstate all the points they've scored on assists today. Beautiful to watch.
Pistons trail by 10. Outside Griffin. He passes to Drummond. And there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
Well, you allow them to get right to the rim like that. That's your only option.
Yeah, I think you got to foul them, and free throws are better than a layup.
For Detroit, they have gone 3 for 3 at the line tonight. That one is off. Los Angeles making a switch here. The second from the line. Now the Clippers with it. They're on a 17-7 run. Dishes to Beverly. Feeds it to George. Good ball movement here by the Clippers. Great open look there. He has 6. We've got 22 seconds left here in the second. And here's Jackson. He's got 8. The pass to Griffin. Outside Jackson. For 3. And that one's good. Jackson's got 11. And so that's the end of the first half. Clippers lead by 9. We're going to step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after our halftime.
Now, presented by Sprint.
Now let's go straight to the Monday night halftime report. The Los Angeles Clippers in front against Detroit. They're scoring effortlessly. The defense has been completely overmatched. Paul George just having his way against the Pistons defense. He's got a dozen points and he's had some good court vision, helping out in the assist department as well. And on the other hand, the Pistons still alive. They've been working the ball inside, getting in close, easy points around the rim. Reggie Jackson making an impact. At the break, 11 points, and as usual, he's been handing out a lot of assists. That'll be all for this episode. It's in the books. I'm all done reading. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoy the second half.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And the second half about to start here in just a few moments. It's been one outstanding game from Paul George.
He went off in the first two quarters, guys, as he's capable of doing. We might see some changes here in the defensive approach they use on him in the second half.
Yeah, they've got to make some sort of change. I mean, they can't let him continue to torch him like he has been.
Now here's Jackson from about 16, and Detroit again with the bucket. Clippers leading by 7. Now here's Leonard. Backs down from 12 feet out. Now Griffin. outside Jackson. Back to Griffin. And Detroit again with the bucket. And for those of you tuning in, we're about a minute into the second half. George dishes to Beverly. The feed now to George. Pocket four. Tries from 10. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
Good strength there. Just barely off with that attempt.
I don't think you can fault him right there. A lot of contact on that one.
The Clippers have made 7 free throws and missed 3 in this game. And he knocks down the first one. Both good from the line that time.
Well, as far as the league's big men go, he's one of the very best at the foul line.
Right around a minute and a half played here in the third quarter. Number 5. And another 3 for Detroit.
Up and in on every one of their first 3 shots to start the second half.
And the Clippers call time here.
Well, it looks like he wants to toy around with some of their sets and matchups here.
You know, I don't think you can afford to go through a whole game doing the same thing over and over. And you have to be able to adjust on the fly, just like he's doing here.
And so here are the Clippers. They've held a 12-point lead early. Outside Leonard. There's the dish to Beverly. Back to Leonard. Outside George. And the shot is good.
He is feeling it. A terrific percentage from the field.
And we're just about 2 minutes into the second half now. Outside Griffin. On the wing, Jackson fires the 3. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
Now still a great start to the half after hitting their first 3 even before that miss.
George passes to Leonard. And that one's good. And now an 8-point Clipper lead. Detroit's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. And that one's good.
Everything's going right now. 4-for-5 shooting, 80%. They got their offense clicking.
He kicks it to Beverly. Pass to George. 3-pointer. The shot is off. Pistons trail by 6. Pass to Jackson. The Pistons working the ball around now. And Griffin backs in. From 13, again, the Pistons score.
I'll tell you what, he's enjoying a very good day shooting the ball so far. He can bring them right back into this.
Outside Leonard. And he drew the blocking foul. He'll go to the line for 2. These are his 3rd and 4th free throw attempts of the game.
2 shots.
First one falls for him. And the Clippers making a change here. Leonard hits them both. A little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now here in the third. He dishes it to Jackson. Number five. Pistons keep it alive. And Griffin backs in. And the Pistons getting another bucket right there.
Really nice work inside there. We'll always give you a battle on the interior, guy.
Leonard kicks to Beverly. Back to Leonard. Outside, George. He feeds it to Leonard. Pass to Beverly. Back to Leonard. From outside the arc. Gets it to go. Leonard's got 7 points for the quarter.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Pistons trail by 7. Now a timeout called by Detroit. Griffin inside. Count that one. Griffin's got 17.
I don't think you can say enough about the quarter he's having. Every one of his attempts has gone down.
Here's Beverly. He's got 10. Back to Leonard. George sets a screen for Leonard. And he dunks it after the pick frees him up.
Taking it hard to the rack for the big throwback.
And give an unofficial assist card to his teammate for setting a screen that freed him up.
Yeah, good call, Kevin. That was really the key to the play.
Pistons trail by 7. Outside Griffin. Kicks to Drummond. Back to Griffin. Hands it from downtown. Griffin's got 20 points.
Great opportunity right there. He's got such tremendous length. He can just rise up and get separation for the three.
Clippers leading by 4. And George kicks to Leonard. Dishes it to Beverly. From the low block. And that's good off the glass that time. Beverly's got 12.
You know, when he gets rolling, guys, he can be an absolute handful to have to deal with. And right now, he is rolling strong.
The drive by Jackson, and lots of contact there. Missing the shot, he'll shoot 2. That one, I'm George.
What a performance. Just look at the game for Jackson. He's got 13 points, and he's picked up 6 points from behind the arc.
Now, his outside stroke has looked really good today.
And that one falls for Jackson. Detroit making a switch here. Morris is checked in. Jackson hits both of them. Clippers leading by 4. Here's Beverly. 12 points for him. And George, here we go. Makes it off the glass. He's got 7.
He really made that mismatch pay off. A defender giving up that much size isn't going to be able to put up much resistance near the basket.
Now, here is Morris. Rose dishes to Jackson. Outside Rose. Feeds it to Jackson. Just 4 to shoot. Off target from 3-point range. For Los Angeles, they've gone 6 of 8 on field goal attempts in the third. A 75% clip. Here's Beverly, guarded by Jackson. George fires and counted from 19 feet away. And now an 8-point Los Angeles lead.
And he was one step ahead of the defense when he fired that pass for the assist.
Detroit's gone 2 of 5 with the three-point shot since coming out of the break. Jackson kicks to Rose. Right side, Rose. Here's Morris. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Los Angeles.
You know, one of the big stories has been the three ball. It's been a key part of their offense throughout the game.
And they're attacking the gaps in the defense with their quick, aggressive drives into the paint area.
First free throw is good. The Pistons making a change here. And Morris drops them both.
Some great free throw shooting so far in this second half.
I think they should keep trying to initiate contact and get back to the line until they start missing from there. But as it is, they're perfect so far, so keep it up.
Gets it to go. Pistons trail by 8. Outside, Rose. He passes it to Morris. Back to Rose. 6 to shoot. From 18 feet away. Nice jump shot. Good. Rose has got his second basket. Clippers leading by 6. Number 40. Great defense that time from Morris.
He worked himself into a really good position there, right near the basket. That's the look he wanted.
Number 6. And the shot is good. 9 points in the game so far.
You can see that they're not as aggressive from the three-point arc. They had far more attempts in the first half.
It's Williams with the drive. 52 seconds left to play in the third. And he gets the shot to fall after coming off the pick. Williams has got 11 points.
Solid screen right there that freed him up for the jump shot.
Pistons trail by 6. Rose with the ball. Rose off the pick from Jackson. Morris passes to Rose. Jackson back to Rose. Jacks up a 3. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson. Jackson's got 6 assists here tonight.
That shot becomes effortless for him when the D is so relaxed. They've got to get more intense.
LA's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. And the pass to Harkins. Now the feed to Williams. And another 3 for the Clippers.
The three-pointer has been his best weapon here today, no question.
The D has been all mixed up, confused, bamboozled. Allowing him way too much space.
Detroit's gotten the three-pointer to fall to the tune of 50% here in the third quarter. They've made 3 of 6. On its way from Rose for 2. Again, the Pistons good for 2.
I'll tell you what, the first half may have been a little slow, but both clubs really picking up the intensity here in the second.
I'll say that for sure. I mean, things have really ramped up here.
And a great show through 3 quarters as we enter the 4th. Who will carry the day?
All right.
The Clippers on top, up by 4. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the 4th quarter. Yeah. All right, we welcome you back to what's been a hard-fought battle. 4th quarter should be good. And the Clippers have possession. Williams kicks to Green. It is now to Beverly. Clippers moving the ball around. Here's Leonard. And you know that's going to be goaltending, guys. So that's a free basket right there.
He thought he had that one clean, but the ref saw it differently. They'll count the basket.
Pistons trail by six. Outside Griffin. Passes to Galloway. He kicks to Drummond. The tray. And he goes in for the dunk.
You know, he may lack grace, but his length makes up for it. He can still throw it down now.
Well, you don't have to be a fantastic leaper when you're his size.
Well, it's too bad, because with a little more athleticism, can you imagine how dangerous he'd be underneath the boards?
Green with a screen for Leonard. Left side, Leonard. Outside, Green. Pass to Williams. Sinks the three-pointer.
Boy, he's putting up big numbers in that three-point column, guys.
One minute now into this fourth quarter. And here's Griffin. He dishes it to Drummond. Back to Griffin. Pass to Galloway. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back.
And where's the defense? I mean, this has been pathetic at both ends.
Yeah, it has been pathetic defensively, but it's been exciting from an offensive standpoint. But if you like defense, then neither one of these teams deserves a win.
Outside Leonard. Leonard off the pick from Green. He feeds it to Beverly. Kicks it to Green. Dishes it to Leonard. Shot clock at five. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. We'll shoot one more at the free throw line.
And this game is really heated up. I didn't think it could get any more high scoring than it already was.
Well, there's always room for more offense, Steve. You know that.
Detroit making a switch here. Jackson's checked in. On the free throw, no good. Pistons trail by six. Griffin kicks to Jackson. A three ball. It's rebounded by Leonard.
He had a couple in the first, but so far he's been unable to get uncorked here.
Outside, George feeds to Beverly. Back to George. Looks up a three. Good. George has got 21.
And this is someone that can really hurt you from long range. He did that to a degree in the first half, and he's doing it now.
Here's Jackson. Number five. He's guarded by Williams. The finger roll finish at the bucket.
You know, when he has that basket in his sights, he will go right at it. Once he's in tight, he is a flawless finisher.
For those just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Here's Leonard. Again, the Clippers.
Easy little jump shot for him right there, guys.
Pistons trail by nine. Jackson kicks to Griffin. Back to Jackson. From deep. It's hauled in by the Clippers. Leonard's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Williams dishes to George. The pass to Beverly. There's the feed to George. There's the three. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
Those are starting to add up. Of their last 5 baskets, 3 of them have been 3-pointers.
And it's not just great offense, Clark. The defense is really lacking. Not enough energy on their closeout.
Time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over. We have to like what we're seeing so far from Kawhi Leonard.
He's getting to the rack all game. If they can't do a better job of keeping him out of the paint, they're in for a long night.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Brooks for an update.
Yes, guys, I was able to hear Dwayne Casey coaching his team during that break. He was was not happy with their play to this point, telling them we're getting out hustled, plain and simple. There's still time, but we've got to dial up our effort. Kevin, we'll see if they have enough to get it done.
Here's the dish to Jackson. Griffin passes it to Drummond. Outside Griffin. Griffin gets a screen from Drummond. Down to five on the shot clock.
It's been a real difficult game for him offensively, and it's costly.
And George kicks to Leonard. He passes to Beverly. Back to Leonard. Whiteside Leonard. Great look there, but off target. Pistons trail by 12. Griffin goes in. He kicks it to Jackson. Fires from the wing. And he hits the jump shot. Here's Beverly. And here's Leonard. Pass to Beverly. Shot clock at six. The Clippers need to get off a shot. A nice shot by George.
You can just see his confidence rising every time he knocks one down beyond the arc.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, the cold stretch offensively, they desperately need a basket.
Griffin passes to Jackson. Snell. That's good, and it's Jackson with the assist that time. Jackson's got assist number 7 for him tonight. Clippers leading by 10. Back to George. Not watching the line there. That'll be a backcourt violation.
You know, that turnover right there isn't typical of the performance he's turned in today. In fact, that's his only turnover of the game. He's done a really good job taking care of the ball.
Derrick Rose has checked in for Detroit. Outside Jackson. Snell releases. And the Pistons getting another bucket right there.
Another good offensive possession for him. He's trying to shoulder the load here for his team.
LA's gotten in the groove from three-point range. They are 4-for-4 since the third quarter ended. Here's Beverly, number 20. Drills the three-pointer. And the Clippers lead by 11.
Three in a row, guys. Three three-pointers consecutively. These guys are just raining in shots.
Yeah, the defenders can't be as soft as they've been on the perimeter there.
Jackson kicks to Griffin. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. And that one misses. Clippers leading by 9. George with the ball. He's picked up by Drummond. Back to George. Left side, George. Out of bounds. Detroit takes possession.
Boy, that's embarrassing, guys. He's going to have a hard time living that one down later when they watch it on tape.
Detroit making a switch here. Pistons trail by 9. Outside Jackson. Snell. Back to Jackson. Nice ball movement by Detroit. Launches a 3. The shot's good for Griffin. Griffin's got 25 points.
He's starting to heat up from outside. That's his second this half.
Los Angeles calls timeout.
Yeah, guys, I think he feels like he can make a few improvements during this timeout. Just kind of make a couple of adjustments, get his club back on track.
You know, coaches are always tweaking and tinkering with things mid-game. Actually, sometimes they overdo it.
Los Angeles leading by six. Outside Leonard. There's a good screen. Pass to George. Just five to shoot. And it comes off the front of the rim.
Major defensive lapse right there. I mean, he's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You got to stay attached to him. They're lucky he couldn't punish them for it.
Griffin kicks to Jackson. Takes the three. Gets it to go. Now it's just a three-point Clipper lead.
Terrible defense for both teams. Just atrocious.
Yeah, it's been awful, Steve. I don't know any other way to say it, and I'm sure both teams will get an earful from their coaches.
Here's Beverly. Back to Leonard. Right side Leonard. A baseline J, and the jumper falls for him. Leonard's got 8 points in the quarter.
How about the boost he's giving his team? He's 4-for-5 shooting here in the fourth quarter.
Now a timeout called by Detroit. They're behind by 5. We've got 1:18 left in the game. We've got 1:18 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Griffin attacking. Snell, he's covered by Leonard. He dishes it to Jackson. He feeds it to Griffin. Just 3 to shoot. The Pistons rebound. Drummond passes to Griffin. Kicks it to Drummond. Deflects the pass. Paul George with the steal. Here's Beverly. Number 40. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
An example right there, guys, of how even as their lead grew into a big one, they never started coasting.
That's the truth. I mean, they've been in charge of this game all the way through.
And the free throw, no good. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Snell. Come! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5. Ball's not loose.
Not much time to work with. They need a basket here.
Yep, they've got to get a steal or foul to stop the clock.
And he commits the intentional foul.
Kawhi Leonard. At the line number 2.
Good on the first, and that increases their lead to 6. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in. Outside Griffin. Nails the tray! Los Angeles calls timeout. They lead by 3. 3 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And now they decide to foul intentionally. It's the first, and that gives them a four-point cushion. And so he drops them both. It's a five-point game.
And that's exactly how you close a game out. Those free throws will bury them for sure.
Time call here. The Pistons decide to talk it over. Guys, what do you think?
Well, they can game plan all they want, but there's not enough time left for them to come back and win this game.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure exactly what they think they're going to pull off here.
On deep, misses the shot. So the Clippers with the win. They pulled off this win, Clark, with respectable performances on both ends of the floor.
Yeah, I think it was just really a nice overall effort, Kevin.
Well, that'll do it. For Doris Burke, Steve Curry, Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying so long. We'll see you next time. And as we leave, we give you our Jordan Player of the Game, the Y London.
Notice your pain.
My pain?
It runs deep. Share it with me.
They'll never take me alive. I'm getting high with my low five cock. Time to die, even as a youngster, causing ruckus on the back of the bus. I was a fool all through high school, kicking up dust, but now